Well, it's impossible now, of course, to think of anyone but Brando playing Terry Molloy wanting to be a contender. But the truth is, the first one signed to play Terry Molloy in this film was Frank Sinatra. Frank was all set for the film until it turned out they could get Brando for it, at which point Frank was rather unceremoniously dumped. All this just after Frank had made his big comeback in From Here to Eternity. Well, Sinatra did not leave quietly. He even sued producer Sam Spiegel, and the case was settled with a financial payoff. But the situation kept Frank rather cool towards Brando the following year when the two of them co-starred in the movie Guys and Dolls. Frank never forgot. Up next, a documentary about the Three Stooges.
Today on Turner Classic Movies, we've got something special in store for you when we present missing episodes of Three Clowns Whose Antics Ruled Slapstick in The Lost Stooges. Then innocent Humphrey Bogart searches for his wife's killer while hiding from the law in a dark passage. And black marketeer Dennis Morgan helps Viveka Linford's escape Nazi assassins in To the Victor. Our stars are victorious today here on Turner Classic Movies.
This month on Turner Classic Movies.
He makes me laugh. He can be funny.
I'd love for him to call me honey. He's got to play so debonair.
This month on TCM.
Our star of the month is William Powell. Funny, sophisticated, and oh so romantic. Thursday nights in February.
These are the pills that made the cut.
They really work, I'll tell you what. It's no mirage.
Yeah. We've got montage this month on TCM.
This month, we've got film editing from the pioneers of the craft through editors turned directors. Wednesday nights in February.
These films have a special grace. He directed A Summer Place.
I love the cowboys, Indians too. He always gives us quite a view.
Our director of the month is Delmer Daves, an accomplished screenwriter and a meticulous craftsman. Saturday nights in February. Plus an outstanding selection of films celebrating Black History Month, Monday nights this month.
The films I love in a special way. They got them here on Valentine's Day.
They're here for you, so say I do. This month on TCM.
It wouldn't be Valentine's Day without lovers, so join us February 14th for a 12-hour wedding movie marathon.
This month
on TCM.
Fall in love with the movies you love all over again.
This month on TCM.
In 1954, Dorothy Dandridge became the first black woman ever to appear on the cover of Life magazine. Sultry and sensuous, with a rich singing voice, the star of Carmen Jones and Porgy and Bess was at one point the toast of Hollywood, the first black ever to be nominated for a Best Actress Oscar. But when she died of a suspected antidepressant overdose in 1965, she was almost broke and hadn't made a film in 3 years.
She had great ability, you know, and tremendous range. And I think she really suffered in her heart because she didn't get a chance to exercise that talent.
You're the one that should do it, but you're a fake.
That's enough.
You're a coward. You're a dirty, rotten, stinking coward.
Singing and dancing her way through childhood, Dorothy performed in Harlem's famed Cotton Club and later won bit parts in movies and musical shorts.
Because she just had the characteristics of both a little girl that you wanted to hold and hug, and also a woman very much in charge of herself.
Good morning, boys and girls.
Good morning, Mr.
Dandridge's first critical movie success came in 1953's Bright Road, opposite newcomer Harry Belafonte. Ultimately paired with the Jamaican performer three times, Dandridge once said, "I would have dumped show business entirely and been happy to be Mrs. Harry Belafonte if he had wanted it that way."
You can talk to your heart, but how can you make it listen?
Drawn to Bright Road's theme that people were simply people beneath any color skin, Dandridge later starred in several films dealing with interracial relationships. But in these movies, desire, anything more than an on-screen kiss, was still too taboo for Hollywood, a notion that greatly distressed Dandridge.
I suggest that while you're on this ship, you wear something a little less revealing.
Does it bother the captain?
Dandridge's private life often resembled her screen image. Two failed marriages and a string of bad investments left her alone and almost penniless. Determined to revive her career, Dandridge decided to return to the nightclub singing, which had brought her so much attention in the first place. But at age 41 and aiming for a comeback, Dorothy Dandridge was found dead in her Hollywood apartment.
It was just a tragic story. You know, when I think about Dorothy Dandridge, I try to think about the high points in her life and the times when she was very happy.
Why don't I walk you down for an ice cream soda?
Why don't you?
Dorothy Dandridge and Harry Belafonte journey down Bright Road, Monday at 10 p.m. Eastern. Part of our salute to small town struggles in black history on Turner Classic Movies.
Not since Gone with the Wind swept the country has any American novel hit the public heart with such mighty impact as J.P. Marquand's best-selling sensation, H.M. Pulham, Esquire. Millions acclaimed its powerful story of romance and applauded its amazing success as a special feature in Reader's Digest, as a stirring serial in McCall's magazine, as a popular Book of the Month Club selection. Now this vibrant story of an ever-faithful love comes to you on the screen, page by page, exactly as written, each heroic moment honestly recreated, each character faithfully portrayed.
Promise me something.
Anything.
Don't ever leave me.
No, of course not.
Just try to forget that there's anyone but me.
Oh, Marvin.
I want to tell you something. No matter what happens,
hiding his heart behind a most terrifying scowl. And of Mama Honorine, a woman, no, a force of nature erupting in the most delightful performance of the decade.
I saw that look in his eyes. It was as close to passion as you can expect from a man of his age. Oh. But too late for love. Never too late for love.
If I ask your daughter to marry me, it won't be because of your threats, but because I love her.
If? What do you mean, if? No, it's not my mother's decision, it's mine.
Well, it's my decision that this marriage will not take place. You're a mad dog, and you ought to be shot.
This is the gun. Shoot.
Put that gun down.
Ibi.
Panice.
No.
Yes, we of Marseille have a great talent to enjoy life. So, why don't you come along and enjoy it with us?
Thank you.
Hi there, I'm Robert Osborne. The next film in our salute to our director of the month, Delmer Daves, is a film he made immediately following our last movie, Dark Passage. The film is called To the Victor, and it was made by Warner Brothers in 1948. And it marks the first time that Delmer Daves directed a movie that was written by someone else. Up to this point, Delmer Daves had either written or co-written all of his previous films. He started out as a writer, you know, and always felt that that was his strong suit. Well, the script we're about to see was written by a man who, like our director of the month, was a writer who would later go on to make a name for himself as a director. His name, Richard Brooks, who eventually directed such films as The Blackboard Jungle, Elmer Gantry, and Cat on a Hot Tin Roof. Our movie, To the Victor, tells the story of an ex-GI who becomes a black market entrepreneur. He lives in France, where he meets and falls in love with a beautiful and mysterious woman whose husband is on trial for being a Nazi collaborator. Dennis Morgan plays the ex-GI. Vivica Lindfors is the mysterious woman. And in real life, she was from Sweden, classically trained at the Swedish Royal Academy of Arts, and a star in her home country. Warner Brothers signed Vivica Lindfors in the hopes of turning her into another Ingrid Bergman, Ingrid also being from Sweden before she came to America and became one of the most popular stars of the day. As for Vivica, this movie, To the Victor, marks her introduction to American movie audiences. Here's the film, To the Victor, with a cast that includes Bruce Bennett and Dorothy Malone. The man who wrote the screenplay for this movie was Richard Brooks, who would later go on to a long and distinguished career as a director. Brooks got his start as a sports reporter in his home city of Philadelphia. Then he moved out to Los Angeles in 1941 to become a writer for radio. He also wrote several novels, then began working on Hollywood screenplays, and he made his directorial debut in 1950 with a film called Crisis, starring Cary Grant. Richard Brooks would eventually direct such high-profile films as The Blackboard Jungle, Elmer Gantry, and Looking for Mr. Goodbar. Now, up next on TCM, Frank Sinatra, Tony Curtis, and Natalie Wood, all working with our director of the month, Delmer Daves.
Welcome to Turner Classic Movies, open all night. While fighting the Nazis, Frank Sinatra tries to win Natalie Wood's heart in Kings Go Forth. Then Sandra Dee and Troy Donahue learn about love while at a summer place. And then unmarried Sandra is in the family way in the comedy, Doctor, You've Got to Be Kidding. Turner Classic Movies is waiting for the stork all night. This month on Turner Classic Movies.
He makes me laugh. He can be funny.
I'd love for him to call me honey. He's got to play so debonair.
This month on TCM.
Our star of the month is William Powell. Funny, sophisticated, and oh so romantic. Thursday nights in February.
These are the films that made the cut.
They really work, I'll tell you what. It's no mirage.
We've got montage this month on TCM.
This month, we've got film editing from the pioneers of the craft through editors turned directors. Wednesday nights in February.
These films have a special grace. He directed a summer place.
I love the cowboys, Indians too. He always gives us quite a view.
Our director of the month is Delmer Daves, an accomplished screenwriter and a meticulous craftsman. Saturday nights in February. Plus an outstanding selection of films celebrating Black History Month, Monday nights this month.
The films I love in a special way. They got
TCM.
It wouldn't be Valentine's Day without lovers, so join us February 14th for a 12-hour wedding movie marathon.
This month
on TCM.
Fall in love with the movies you love all over again.
This month on TCM.
Come on. on, come on. We're gonna have a ball. Just leave your cares and woes and let your troubles fall. You'll find a starry sky behind that cloud you're under. It's such a perfect time for one real wonder.
Waterfront is the home world, Tom. The much bigger world beyond here. And someday you're going to be part of it. Important part of it.
Look for the silver lining whene'er a cloud appears in the blue. Remember somewhere the sun is shining, so always look for the silver lining and try to find the sunny side of life.
Today on Turner Classic Movies, we're lighting the candles on director Norman Taragg's birthday cake. First Irish cop George Murphy bickers with his bullheaded father-in-law in Little Nellie Kelly. Then Judge Rosalind Russell slaps a hefty alimony payment on publisher Edward Arnold in Design for Scandal. And American Mickey Rooney is befriended by Brits Peter Lawford and Freddie Bartholomew as a Yank at Eton. Norman Taragg calls the shots on Turner Classic Movies today.